My name is Rio, and welcome back to yet another Match Day vlog. So, of course, today I will be going to Edgar Street as Chester FC player at Hereford FC in what is our second away match in the space of 4 days. So, you know, as you may know, Wednesday we lost 3-0 away at Southport, so we really got to bounce back today because our away record isn't too great now because, the last time we won an away match was way back on September the 15th where we beat Boston United 2-0, so we really got to win today, because we've got a few, we've got three matches in the next 7 days, which are, of course, Hereford today. Southport's home on New Year's Day, then of course next Saturday we'll be going to FC United in Manchester. So yeah, can't wait for the game, it should be a great day out for me. So can't wait for the match, so of course hope you enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like, subscribe to my channel as always, also comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. So it's fair to say Hereford FC have had another side who've had a mixed season so far because, as you may know, last season they got promoted from the EFO 6 Southern League and they started off the season quite well, to be honest, because on the opening day they beat Blythe Spartans at home 3-0, but since then they have dropped down quite remarkably really because a lot of people thought that they would be near the promotion spaces now, but right now they are just one place above the relegation zone on goal difference as well, because their goal difference is minus 12 and FC United and Manchester's goal difference is minus 13, so it's a really tight margin there. But they have struggled a lot this season. So during September, it was a bit of a surprise to some Hereford fans. But their manager Peter Beadle, he actually got sacked. So Hereford, since they reformed in 2014, they actually got three promotions in as many seasons. So Peter Beadle, he got sacked for them in September. So it was a bit of a surprise to the Hereford faithful. And when we beat Hereford home in October, on October the 2nd, 3-0. Just hours before the game, actually, Hereford, they appointed a new manager. His name is Mark Richards, and he came from Gloucester City. So he hasn't really done too well for them so far, but fair play to them. They have actually won 4 of the last 5 games, and also they've only lost 1 match in the last 6. So they are on a good run of form right now. So we're not playing them, we're playing them today at a bit of a wrong time, really. So be interested to see what happens today. But Hereford, just like us, really, they've had their fair share of trouble lately because in 2014 Hereford United went bust, and as you may know, in 2010 Chester City went bust. Actually, in the 2013-2014 season, we technically got relegated, so we finished 21st that season, so we occupied the final relegation spot. But due to Hereford going bust, we actually got a reprieve, so that was really good news for us at the time. But also, it was really sad news to, for Hereford United going bust. So just months later, a new club called Hereford FC reformed, and that's what they're known as right now, Phoenix Club. And as I told you a minute ago. They got 3 promotions in a row, so just like us really, in 2010 we reformed under the name of Chester FC, which is what we are right now, and we got 3 promotions in a row as well. So a bit of a similar theme going on there, so isn't it? So yeah, a bit two similar clubs. Hereford, they got a really nice ground called Edgar Street. It holds just under 5,000, so but it's a really nice old fashioned stadium. So first of all, you got the main stand, which is the Merton stand, and it's a really nice stand. It is raised above pitch level. Interestingly, it's actually got red seats. So as you may know, Hereford, they play white and black, but all the seats in that stand are actually red. So I don't know why, but maybe it's just Hereford they didn't want to change the colour. So yeah, it's a nice old seat to stand, and opposite that is the Len Weston stand, and it's a bit of a strange affair really, because it is actually a two-tier stand. So about this level of football steps, it's quite rare that you see two-tier stands at this level, but Hereford, they have got one. So the Len Weston stand, so the bottom tier was just a terrace really, it's a nice covered terrace, and the top tier was just an all-seater. So it's just all black seats at the top, and I have looked at a few photos of that in fitness space, and it's a bit tight there. So I'd be interested to see what it's like today, and because our supporters will be there today. I'm going to be on the lower tier because I prefer to stand up at the away matches, but that we'll be allocated half of that stand, and behind one goal is the Meadow, and it's a bit of it's a bit of a quirky stand really, because it's got an oval shape going around it. So it's a covered terrace and it looks really nice, but you've got like an oval shape going around, so it's a bit odd really. Then behind the other goal is the Black Variety, and then again, just like the Meadow End really, it's just like a covered terrace with an oval going around it. But it's actually not going to be open today. For the last couple of years it has been closed because I do believe they are doing a bit of work on there, so I don't know whether it's going to be reopened again, but it's going to be closed today. So yeah, it's a really nice stadium, Edgar Street. I've never been there before, so I really can't wait for the game today. That's why Robert Sales, though, as I said before, our away record hasn't been too great this season. We've only won two matches, so our first away game of the season, we beat Curzon National away 3-0 back in August, and of course on September the 15th, beat Boston United away 2-0. So we need to be picking up the points today if we are to be up there come the end of the season, because, as I say, Hereford, they aren't doing too well this season. So, you know, it's going to be a good game today, hopefully. And our most previous meeting was back in October, where we beat Hereford at home 3-0. So hopefully we can expect a similar result today. So can't wait for the game. And there is a bit of a connection for today's game, because, as you may know, Hereford have a player called James Roberts, who was a striker. In 2015, he had a brief loan spell here, where we actually scored another 3-2 win against Wrexham. So that locked down the road. So, he'll receive my respect today, but hopefully he'll be on the losing side come 5 p.m. today. So can't wait for the game. It should be a fantastic occasion. So, never been to Hereford before, so hopefully we can take a good following today. I believe, around the 300 marks, that'd be fantastic, especially, we've got, three matches over the next 7 days. So can't wait for the game. Also, of course, hope you enjoyed the video today. So then, my score prediction is Hereford FC 0, Chester FC 2. So I do think we'll win today. I do think we'll get back to midway. So I do think Anthony Dudley and George Green will score for us today. So George Green, hopefully he can starting for us today, because he hasn't played for us lately due to an injury. So can't wait for the game today. So hopefully we can get a big win today, because, we need to be picking up these wins away. Of course, hope you enjoyed the video today. Like and subscribe as always, so of course, hope you enjoy it. Please leave a like and also comment down your thoughts on the game below. So come on, City, my match highlights are recording up right now. So come on, you Blues, let's make it a great away day. Come on, City, let's do this, lads. Come on, lads, come on. Come on, City! Yellow! Come on, City! Here is Hereford FC's squad for today's game. Here is Chester FC's squad for today's game. So in goal is 1 Grant Shenton, in defence is 2 Matty Thomson, 3 Symons Grant, 5 Jon Moran and 6 Steve Howson. In midfield is 4 Captain Gary Roberts, 7 Dan Mooney, 8 George Green, 9 Bradley Jackson and 11 Craig Mahon. Up front is number 10 Anthony Dudley. Then the substitutes bench is
12 Deane Smalley, 14 Matty Waters, 15 Cain Noble, 16 Adam Dawson, and 17 Lloyd Marsh-Hughes. So enjoy the game, come on City, let's bring the 3 points home. What are you playing at, Lino? Come on! Away!
on, you lads!
Hereford FC 2, Chester FC 0. So I've just got back from the game. Now it's 8 o'clock and it, boy, it has been a long journey home because I must admit that was absolutely awful today. That was terrible for me. That was the worst performance I've seen this season. I've been to every single game apart from two, for one, I missed the Dunstan game due to me being in Iceland and also missed the York City away game, you know, because I had other commitments. But boy, that was awful. Even the Blythe Spartans game was better than this one today. You know, just no fight at all, no desire. And I know we've been doing really well this season, but we've really got to improve our away record now if we are to be up there come the end of the season, because it's now been 3 months, nearly 4 months actually, since our last win on the road. So we've really got to improve that now, because we have got the best home record in the league, and that is absolutely fantastic. You know, I'm really enjoying games for the home matches now. It's it's a pleasure to you know, to go to all the home matches now, but away from home, been really poor. We've only won two matches all season, so today, no excuses really for that display today. It was just effortless. It was absolutely awful, and Hereford, fair play to them. You know, Hereford, they more than deserve to win today, but boy, we made them look like Barcelona today. But, you know, Hereford, they did really well today. They were by far the better team. We were awful. We were hopeless. And, you know, really do hope that we can improve from that now, because, you know, as I say, it's only two games. You know, prior to that, we were on a really good run of form. You know, I'll admit that. But, you know, and especially at Southport and, of course, today at Hereford, you know, being really poor. So hopefully we can improve on that, because, as I say, we've got two really important matches now over the next 7 days. So really got to improve on that, because the season is nowhere near over yet. We've still got about 20 games to go yet, so yeah, still really poor today, no excuses for that. So the first half was awful. Hereford, they got off to, you know, a really good start, because they played some nice football. You know, it's a really good pitch today. I did like the pitch pattern there today. It was a really nice pitch. Hereford, they were playing some really good football. They had a few chances as well, and you know, we made it far too easy for them. We were you know, ducking away from challenges. We were giving away far too many balls. You know, the amount of times they gave the ball away today was unbelievable. I'm not going to name any names today, not going to name and shame, because at the end of the day, you know, it's just one game. But, you know, the amount of times we gave the ball away today was, you know, not unacceptable, really. So, you know, in the first half, Hereford were really good today. I thought they had a few really good chances. And on the 30th minute mark, they made it 1-0. It was Danny Greenslade who, you know, fired it home. It was, you know, it was really poor defending because there was no one closing him down at all. Grant Shenton, he had no chance really, so it was a really poor goal to concede. And just prior to that, a few minutes before that, on the 20th minute mark, Matty Thomson, one of our best players on the pitch today, he went down with a really serious injury. It did look really bad from where I was standing today, and I do believe he has damaged his ligaments. That is a really, really serious injury, really because he's been one of our best players lately. To be fair, he has been thrown in at the deep end lately because, as you may know, Don Smalley has been out on loan lately. So, I really feel sorry for the lad because he has been really good lately. He's been one of our best players in recent times. So, he went off injured today. So, hopefully for the lad, he will be back fit soon because it did look really serious. So, he went down and also Hereford, they made it 1-0, as I said a few minutes ago. As the half went on, Hereford, they just kept them dominating us. But to be fair, in the last 5 to 10 minutes, I thought we played some decent football, but still, not good enough really. We just stuck backing away from challenges, giving the ball away for fun, and it was just a heartless display today. So the whistle for half time just couldn't be blown sooner enough really. So but the second half, though, I thought the second half was even worse really today. I thought the first half was awful, but the second half was abysmal. It was that bad really because we just kept on giving the ball away far too many times. We just didn't have any creativity today. A fourth of quality chance was a massive miss for us today because, Anthony Dudley, he was on his own up top today and he just didn't have any service today. But there again, he didn't put in the best of displays today. So, lots of key players today. Quality Sante, Scott Burton, Gary Stopforth and Matty Hughes as well, Daniel Iffersy as well, who have all been key players for us this season. But, yeah, we have missed, five key players for us today. So, that did play on today's defeat. But still, no excuses for the team for not pulling in the effort today. So the second half, however, they continued to absolutely dominate us, and they made it 3-0. They made it 2-0, where it was Mike Symons who it's really poor defending. Again from a corner, he just failed to clear our line. So Mike Symons, he just stroked it home into the far corner. So it's a really poor defending. Yes, again, from there on, we just didn't recover from that really. So an awful day at the office. So my journey home from Hereford, it was a really miserable one, and so was our other supporters. But to be fair, we took a really good following today. We took 354, and that was outstanding. Considering we've had we had an away game 4 days previous to this, and also we got two matches next week. So that is a phenomenal following from us today. But again, we just haven't been rewarded with that today. So, hope to God that we can improve it, really soon, because we have got two really important games now over the next weeks. We've got Southport at home on New Year's Day, and of course, this time next Saturday, we're away to FC United and Manchester. So anything less than 6 points in those two games, it won't be good enough for us really. So I'm really, disappointed, with this result today, because we just weren't at the races at all today. It was a really poor performance. So I hope to God that we can improve on that now, because, as I say, it has been two games for us now where we have been really poor, but prior to that we have done really well. So we can bow out to 2019 with a bit of a low note, but still Burton, John and all of our players have done really well for us this season. So just got to hope that we can make 2019 a year to remember really. We've still got a long way to go yet, but today, no excuses at all. It was just a poor performance. So our next game is at home against Southport on New Year's Day. That is on Tuesday. So as ever, I will be going to the game today. Won't have a bit of a downside on it, but can't wait for the game. As always, it will be a change. So hopefully we can continue our good records at home. So can't wait for the game. Also, of course, we'll upload the match day vlog and the preview out shortly. So of course, if there are of you Hereford fans watching this video right now, I do hope you enjoyed it. But for the Chester fans, I don't think you will enjoy it. So of course, hope you enjoyed the video today. Like and subscribe as always. Also, comment down your thoughts on the game below. So really bad day at the office today. Words can't describe how awful it was today. But we will go again on Tuesday. So yeah, join me on Tuesday where we'll be at the Southport game. So it just wasn't to be today, but hopefully it's onwards and upwards from now on.